for it, Jason. Give us your things. Do you have one for everybody? You only have for certain people.
I actually wrote one for everyone, including evicted people too.
Okay.
They're probably not that good.
They're that good, Jason.
Julia, thanks for trying to control your sister. You suck at it. Shelly, so I know you regret turning your back on me, but I'm glad because then I could see how cheap your extensions look.
Very long-awaited show that we are also super duper excited for. We have a very special Big Brother 17 guest here that I know you guys are excited to talk to. But before we get to that, first, if you guys want to see our other interviews with Audrey, with Jeff, they'll all on yourrealityrecaps.com/BB17. And check out our Patreon. We updated it. If you want to help our shows, help us bring you guys more shows, or become a fan on YouNow, younow.com/realityrecaps. You guys know the deal. You can follow me over on Twitter. I'm at Reality Recaps.
Okay, everybody, we're for Really Real Life. Guys, I am so sorry. That was totally my fault. Jason and I have already done the start of this show twice on our testing channel, and somebody wasn't smart enough to realize that we weren't on the right channel. Probably the two of you that know about our test channel was there. But okay, you guys are all here. Thank God. Hundreds of you chat room. Awesome. That's how I know I'm in the right place. Let me just tell you guys really quickly, if you want to send your questions to Jason, tweet me with them with hashtag YRRLive. That way we can answer your questions live. You can follow Jason and I. Our Twitters are right down here. And if for some reason this flashes off or clicks off, just stay in the chat room. We're coming right back. That said, let's get to the man of the hour, the one you all want to hear from, not me, and it is Jason.
Hey, what's going on?
Jason is thrilled to do. Jason is thrilled with the third time we're doing this intro. Okay, so now Jason, for really real, chat room screaming for you, screaming for you. I have to say, Jason, every time we do a YouNow, all anybody asks is, when's Jason coming? Where's Jason? We love Jason. Jason fans, Jason. They're all yours, Jason. They love you.
Hey, it's nice to know. It's still so weird, though.
It's not weird. Jason, you're a fan favorite. We're making that happen.
Oh, okay. Well, not if Johnny Mac or James go home this week.
Okay, I don't know where the Johnny Mac love comes from. Girlfriend through POV. Uh-huh. Wasn't trying to save himself last night with Vanessa. I don't know what he's doing with this game. I don't know why everybody likes him. I get it. He's a human Muppet that drills people's faces. But that's not enough for me to love Johnny Mac. He's going to need to do something in the game if people want me to like him, is what I'm saying.
I mean, that's a valid point, but in there, it looks like he's doing absolutely nothing, and then you come out, and you're like, well, he actually is doing something. I mean, they are talking to him in the diary room. That's more than Becky got.
It's true. That is more than Becky got. Who would you want to come back out of the people that are there now?
Jackie. My girl, Jackie.
Don't get me wrong. I want a Jackie side-eye back in that house as much as anybody else does, but she didn't get Vanessa out when she was on the block. She let Vanessa manipulate her out of that. That's what scares me about Jackie coming back in.
You know what? I don't necessarily think that was Jackie's decision. Honestly, for the little goblin side of the house, Meg seems to be the social one. She's the one who is coming up with the ideas, and everyone is just sort of running with what Meg thinks. So I actually blame Meg for saving Vanessa that week.
Whoa, really?
I really do. Because I know being in there that Meg was steering a lot of us. And as much as she couldn't win a physical comp if her life depended on it, she does have the social savviness to sort of steer the group in whatever direction that works best for her. So I think for her, maybe it was good for Shelley to go. But for James and Jackie, I think it would have been smarter for Vanessa to go.
Really? I mean, yeah, definitely. I could definitely see that. Chat room question. Now, this is my question for the chat room, because this has happened before. Some people are saying, oh my God, it sounds like we have chipmunk voices. Is that for all of you or just like one or two of you? Because that seemed to be a problem for people.
I pretty much got that already.
That's what I said, Jason, too. I was like, that's just our normal voices, everybody. No. Okay, so no, you guys hear us. There are definitely yous in the chat room who hear us fine. No, okay, you say we're fine. Guys, it appears to be something wrong with the YouNow app on some people's mobile devices, so it's not us. There you go. Chat room says it's not us. By the way, Jason, you don't have a YouNow, or you said you do, but you're just not on it?
I think I might have created one when someone asked me first to do it, and then I was like, I don't even understand this website, and I just left it. So, like, pretty much even I just created a Facebook and it's been complete chaos and I haven't opened my Facebook since.
Okay, so basically I'll translate that for all of you guys. What Jason wants you all to do is click in my YouNow, clickety click click, and become a fan of us. Or if you're on a mobile device with Chipmunk Voices, the little man with the plus arrow, and then I will bring Jason back here for you. So make sure you're following us or a fan or whatever it is on our YouNow then. Or Audrey's, whatever. Okay, Jason. Now, there's a lot of Twitter rumors or whatever going around. I think a lot of fans like to kind of create drama about nothing. Mm-hmm. I've seen a lot of people saying, like, Audrey, Clay, Jace were all together this past week, but, like, you and Javon weren't there, and you guys are fighting. And I'm like, or they just all live by each other. Oh, but go ahead, Jason. Yeah. Floor is yours. Go ahead.
Well, I think people assume that it means me and Davon are like the Sour Patch Kids and that we hold something against these people. I live in New England. That is nowhere near Atlanta. I went on this show to win some damn money because he is poor. I do not have $300 to go drop on an airplane ticket to go hang out with Audrey for a week. I would have loved to, because it would have been a great week and it would have been nice and out of normal life and out of my normal area. But I don't have the money to blow. So if they wanted me to come, they could have sent my ass a ticket, because he can't afford that.
Now, I don't know if you heard, Jason, but this is what the Big Brother people do. They create GoFundMes for everything they want to do. So you should have made like a GoFundMe. I want to hang with Audrey.
People would want to go hang with Audrey, and people would pay for it. Okay, not a bad idea.
Look, I will help. Jason, I told you, if you need help, we're here for you. Chat room, somebody go create a GoFundMe for Jason's travel expenses. So that clears that up. Exactly. Sounds like you're agreeing with me. You guys don't live near each other. I don't know why that was so.
I would have loved to go on, but it just, everyone that actually lives near me is still in the house. I'm the only like New England northerner home, and they all just happen to be Florida, in the South, in Texas. So it's easier for them, where I'm a bit removed.
Exactly. Well, we're in New York, Jason. You can come hang out with us. We have like a guest room. We have the Hamptons. Well, you know, I'm sure you come to New York. You're not that far away. Thanks for coming to fan, guys. Joey Gachefa in our chat room, Jason, is a huge Jason fan. He's one of those people that are always like, say hi to Jason, say hi to Jason. So letting you know, Joey's here to see you. Tons of people are all freaking out for you. Angel Chick and Tawana, Kim is bored. Everybody, he loves all you guys.
Kim is bored makes me laugh. I love you, Kim is bored.
She is very funny. She's very funny. Now, speaking of not at all Kim is bored, what did you think of the Zingbot not understanding what your job is with his Zing for you?
Well, you know, it did said that on the CBS show the whole time. When I actually started applying, I was a cashier. And then pretty much right after, I became a stalker overnight. So I know it sounds a little bit better to say cashier. Like, overnight stalker, that doesn't look good under Jason. So I get on why maybe CBS didn't reference it at all, but it's just so funny that I can't even get away from it. And I'm like, I haven't even done that job in like a year. How is it that I'm bagging people's groceries? But I get it. During my intro video, we sort of did me at a checkout counter. So that definitely makes people confused. Mm-hmm. And, when I said it on Twitter yesterday, like for the fourth millionth time, I think people started to think like, I think people thought like Zingbot actually got to me. I'm like, no, I'm just clarifying because the 900 questions are da 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 all about that. So I love to make fun of myself. I love anyone that tries to make fun of me. It was kind of a lame joke, but at least I got a zing. Then I zing myself back to him saying, what you should have said is the only thing weaker than my social game is my lungs.
Nailed that.
Oh, we got sound effects.
First of all, that I totally see what they're doing. I see what they're doing. I don't really like that they, I mean, I would guess that they have an intern running that account. Anyway, it needs to be a little bit more original. But again, Jason, we got ideas for you. We're here to help you. We got ideas. Here's how you take that and you turn it around. You need your own, like, web show, like, Google Hangout, whatever you want to do. Kind of like how Adam Pock does tofu or bacon. You need Jason Roy, paper or plastic. And you can make it like I'm putting the plastic over someone's head means you're killing them. They're out of the game. Paper bag means we're like recycling on Earth. I don't know. I didn't think it through enough. But I got the title. I got the title for you. I didn't think it through more than that.
I'm going to say that's pretty good, though.
It is. Totally do it. Do it. All right. You guys start giving us your questions kind of slowly in the chat. I don't mean slowly. I mean, I'm going to try and read them with your chat room flying. Did you see any of the zings for the house guest last night? Are you like caught up on any of the zings, Jason?
No. I mean, I've just recently brought my little live feeder brain to the live feeds. At first, I was like, I'm not going to do this, but I couldn't help myself. And I wasn't really listening last night to them recounting what their zings were. I heard that Austin was something about him being smelly, but of course. And I heard something that Liz's was about Austin's girlfriend, which I really think they should have saved for Austin. It's not Liz. Liz can do. She's a grown woman. She's not attached to no one. If she wants to sleep with your man, that's her problem. That should have been his thing because he's the one who's actually doing the wrong in that situation.
Well, are you saying that Big Brother? No, I'm sorry. I shouldn't even joke about that because I'm not going to joke. I'm gonna flip that around. I'm saying me on behalf of myself, Eric, thinks that Big Brother is misogynistic. And this is just exactly what they did to Christine. Let's make the girl the whore in the scenario when it's both people participating in it. And I think it's ridiculous and stupid. And Twitter seems to feel the same way.
Very valid.
That's what I'm saying. I mean, it's ridiculous. I'm not a Liz fan by any means, but I'm also not, I don't like when they try and force a storyline or try and force an edit to America and then kind of just like push you guys out into it and like have fun dealing with that. We made a whole storyline about you. Have fun. You're a whore. Welcome back to the world. I think Christine has handled it very well, though. I feel bad.
I think Christine has handled it very well. Her Twitter persona now is completely different than the girl that got booed when she got voted out. So she has done a full-fledged turnaround.
Yeah, I mean, I don't even know that she did a turnaround. I think that was always Christine. And I mean, people were shocked. The second she came out of the house, she was all about fans, all about doing stuff with fans, interacting with them, not charging them. And people were surprised. They were like, hey, she's for the fans. I mean, she was a fans fan. And by the way, she loves you. And if she wasn't on vacation right now, she would be here. Because she was like, Eric, I have one request. I want to be on a show with Jason. And I was like, all right, we're going to do it. But she's on the vacay, which I hope I'm allowed to say. And if I'm not, sorry, Christine.
Sorry, Christine.
Sorry, Christine. Love you. Everybody desperately wants you in the house. Chat room wants you in the house. They miss your Horkini. They miss your Horkini, Jason.
Oh, my
Jason, is what did you think of your
comment? I should have never been wearing those. Oh my gosh.
That's
the only thing I'm embarrassed about is coming out and seeing that, like, my balls were hanging out on TV.
You are lucky I haven't figured out how to pull up pictures yet. Otherwise, I would have told people to start tweeting me and we would have pulled that up. I don't know how I missed that. Speaking of stuff that people in the house aren't thinking is on TV, what's your take on the whole finger bang gate? Or do you not know? Ooh. Oh, yeah.
Okay. I mean, I don't think CBS is really going to reference Fingergate too much. I mean, it is a family show. Fingergate is something else. I mean, it's not the first time we've ever seen this happen in the house. I mean, please, I've done watched April and Ollie go at it for 20 minutes on YouTube. So, I mean, it's not that shocking, but I think it just has a new level this year because with the Austin's girlfriend and how we feel about Austin, we've had lots of hooking up before and it's never been as much of a gate as this has been.
100%. First of all, Julie alluded to it in the opening of Thursday's show. She said something like, tonight's episode's going to be it's a banging hot summer. She said something where it was clear that's what she was talking about. And I wish I could remember the wording right now, but I was like, okay, let's not try and be clever, Julie. Now, that's number one. Number two, I thought it was a family show too, Jason, until your diary room when you were like, she's a douchebag bitch. Or like, what was it? Did you watch that episode?
A scumbag bitch.
Yeah. I remember I was like, and my nephew and niece watch, like, I've gotten my sister to watch, and like, my sister, and she, like, literally 5 minutes of the episode's over, she's like, oh, that's awesome. I'm now explaining to them what a scumbag bitch is. So tell CBS 3 said, thank you. No, Jason, I'm not blaming you. I think congratulations. I think you set a Big Brother record history. I don't think anybody has ever, if we're calling that a curse, cursed.
Oh, I said bitch that much on the show. Oh my god.
Well, air.
Challenge. I called every one of those girls bitches. I'm glad they didn't edit that way because I just kept grabbing and saying, you bitch, come with me.
Oh, that would have been, we need that. I mean, we need more of it. We definitely need more of the cursing on the show.
If the show aired at like 11 p.m. on Showtime, I would have been the star of the show. But since it's 8 o'clock on CBS, they like, we whittled everything Jason has to say down to one appropriate sentence.
But to then their credit and to your credit, I mean, everybody still talks about you. I completely went on Tumblr. I don't know if you saw my tweet earlier today. I went on Tumblr to, like, promote this show, and they have you featured. It's like Jason Roy. I tweeted out. If you look at my Twitter here.
I'll have to go look at it.
I'll see if I can pull it on up right here. I'll pull it on up. People want to see. They want to see Jason. Here we go. Look. Tumblr. Wait, I got to figure out. I'm all backwards. See, it's like you.
Oh, it's the yes, bitch, yes.
It's the yes, and you were right there. It's trending on Tumblr, and that was a staff person at Tumblr wrote about you. You were, like, featured at the top of Tumblr. I was like, oh, what a great day for that. Look, everyone, it's Jason. So, yeah, I mean, when I see a lot of articles, magazines, things on the web referencing Big Brother, they're using you. They're using your one-liners, things that you said. I can't think of another phrase that's going to come out of this season other than, oh, my Lanta. So, okay, Jason, I'm just telling you, fan favorite. Chat room, make that happen. Chat room, it's up to you. At CBS Big Brother. All right. Speaking of chat room, who that's left in the house right now, Jason, they want to know who in the house right now would you want to win?
I would want... I mean, see, this is a hard question because I have such personal relationships, and then I also have, like, the Big Brother fandom in me that's out here. And the Big Brother fandom in me would like to see Johnny Mack win, actually. but the player glue goblin in me, I want to see Megan James down in those two final chairs. That's probably going to be impossible, but I think Meg may have a good chance. I could see a Meg versus Liz final two. I don't think Meg would necessarily win in that scenario, but I would love to see her try. And I would love James to win. He probably needs it as much as, like, I did. A lot of these people are silver spoon people. They don't really know what a real damn job is. James is not that person.
Exactly. I mean, I think we could, well, first of all, yes, I agree with that, which is why I should tell you, Big Brother people you want to hook up with, Amanda, I'm trying to think of all the other hard work ones. They're slipping my mind, but yes. And you don't really have to worry about it that much because I'm pretty sure didn't Vanessa. I mean, we got it on film, Vanessa. We got it on film.
I mean, we did. I'm not holding my breath, though. We'll see. I think the minute I called her a scumbag bitch, that might be.
Oh, no. Oh, come on. She gets it's a game. Don't you watch? She gets it's a game. She gets it's a game. She's going to be fine. She's totally giving you money. And I have a feeling if she doesn't, Twitter's going to remind her over and over.
She's going to be afraid of Twitter when she comes back. She should just remove herself.
Do you think she's really going to go on Twitter? I mean, she's a multimillionaire. The way she plays...
She's got Lamborghinis to drive around and shit.
And the way she plays this game, I kind of have a feeling she's going to be the person postseason. She's not really going to associate with any of you. She's not really going to do anything. She's just going to go back to her. Like, this was just, she had an agenda, a goal. She's moved on. Bye, everybody.
Oh, she just wanted to get on TV bad. She'd been doing The Amazing Race and Survivor. She applied to everything for years. She finally got her, like, she doesn't have enough money, but now she's got her TV break. She's got what she's wanted. She's not really there to be friends with us. She's going to go back to her girlfriend and the yellow Lamborghini and the mansion.
Did you not see her GoDaddy commercial?
I have not seen the GoDaddy commercial.
Damn it. Of all the time I have to be on this software, because we pulled it up on the last show.
I'm going to have to go search.
I'll tweet it to you after. She's like the worst actress. It's like, I'm playing poker. What do you mean you're going to deal me in?
Well, you know, I've seen lots of footage of lots of the house guests this year. It seems like everybody had, like, been on camera before, and I was the only one. I went through, like, media on Joke This updates, and I'm like, well, at least there's nothing on me, but there's 400 pictures of Liz, there's all these interviews with Vanessa, and Vanessa comes off just as boring in every single one. How the hell anyone said that she was interesting enough to put on TV is beyond me.
But do you think she's playing a good game? Because I feel like she's playing she's controlling that house.
Oh, her game is on point. We have not seen a female puppet master like her in years. I mean, Amanda Zuckerman is the closest we've gotten in the last 5-6 years. And her mouth is kind of like my mouth and what ruined it for her. Now, Vanessa doesn't use her mouth. She uses her tear ducts. Mm-hmm. So it's a little bit different. It's a different way of approaching it. And I think it's working out better for Vanessa than it did for Amanda.
Well, yeah, because as we all saw with Amanda, the gay took her out. Oh, wait, why can't we do it?
Never trust the gay.
I told Andy I would do that. got to figure out a good sound effects on here, too. All right. Well, speaking of Vanessa, I'm going to make this Twitter question about Vanessa. But, Jason, Kathy Chronicles wants to know, what do you think of what's going on in the house right now? I don't know if you've seen I know you talked about it a little, and honestly, I don't remember if that was on the fake show or this one. But I will say specifically with Vanessa, and I don't know if you saw a little bit earlier, right before this show started, she kind of cornered Steve and was like, you didn't have my back. I know that I was the backdoor plan. I know you would have voted against me. Why did you do that? Why did you say that? Why weren't you with me? And Steve kind of threw Austin and the twins under the bus. So you think that's good play on Steve's part? Do you
No.
I mean, I don't really think that's life-changing at this point. I think everybody knows where Steve's at. He's just going to do what whoever with side is in power tells him to do. And I think Vanessa, if she knows that she was possibly the back door, I mean, she pretty much knows that her relationship with Aust twins is disjointed anyway. So I don't think that's any new information really thrown out there. That's maybe just confirming what everybody already knew.
Well, I mean, Vanessa didn't know. Nobody, like, this is, I mean, really last night was the first time Vanessa found out that she was pretty much the backdoor plan. Yes, the rest of the house knew, but Vanessa really didn't know. And then you know Vanessa when she, I need to understand. All I want you
to... I would have loved Austin to get her out just for, like, my own personal, as you got me out instead of Austin, and then who gets you out? Austin. So I'm actually still hoping that Austin is the person that sticks the nail in her coffin. As much as I can't stand him, I'd love him to be the one to ship her off.
Yeah, but I don't think it's going to happen this week. Look, I don't think it's going to happen any week. I think Vanessa is guaranteed final two.
That's a valid point. She might be. She's down farther enough where people think everyone has a problem with Vanessa. You take her to final two. She's your BB Can Sabrina. But I don't necessarily think that if you put her in one of those final two chairs, that you're going to easily snatch all the votes. Because she's going to have 90,000 reasons on why she outplayed all of us, which would be really true reasons. And then unless the jury is bitter as hell, they have to.
Yeah, I mean, I think the jury is made up of game players, right? I mean, Shelly's a game player. Jackie, okay, I don't think she... Becky, no. Recruit. Well, whatever. We only got really one gamer in there so far. But, all right, you're right.
I mean, as it fills up, I mean, it might be... Now it's nine people. It could be like five people on the recruit. We're not voting. We're voting on how we personally like. And then there'll be the four doing the, this is how Big Brother is played. This is how we're supposed to vote, which will probably be like the Steve and the Shelleys.
The Steve. Well, yeah. I mean, I think, do you think if Vanessa made it into jury, she would make her vote personal?
You know, that's a hard one. Because as much as she is a game player, you'd like to think she's going to go the game route. But she's so emotional. And if she thinks that somebody has done her dirty, she takes that to, like, the full extent. So she could possibly be the most bitter jury member in years.
Which I kind of want to see.
God, it'd be great.
I want to see it.
TV.
All right. So speaking of jury, but I guess kind of not really, Princess Glammy wants to know, Jason, are you excited to attend the finale? And who are you happy to see the most?
I am so excited to attend the finale. Obviously, it'll be the first finale I've ever attended for my damn favorite show ever. And I'm going to be on stage to get asked no questions by Julie, but it will still be just nice to be there. I'm going to be so excited to see Devon, obviously.
Mm-hmm.
And I am going to be so excited to see a lot of people still in there. Like, Jackie, Meg, James. And, you know, even a lot of the people who I didn't get along with in there, or even right as they first came out, I would even be excited to see Liz at this point. Because as much as we never connected on a game level, when it really came down to it, we have similar personality types. We're kind of like the sassy bitches. So that the sassy bitches never combined is like that. Of course, we weren't going to on Big Brother. But in the outside world, I don't think Liz and Julia would annoy me as much as they did in that house.
Okay. Okay, Jason.
Read me down.
Jason, from one basement to another.
Yeah.
A girlfriend called you out for living in your mom's basement like an insult on national TV. Now, this is what I'm going to say about her. If that was, and you're not allowed to comment on this, a line fed to her by the DR to say, I might be more understanding. However, it seemed like that was coming from her on that one.
Yeah.
But okay, I get it. I get it. Yes, she's a little bitchy, and you shouldn't hold a grudge. Let it go.
I talk trash about everyone in there, so you really can't be that mad. Like, good thing they never played my good way message for Jeff Weldon, because I had just drank a half bottle of wine, and I went off in there. So, it's one of those, everyone talks trash, that's what you're there to do. I'm not someone who takes anything that personal, so to me, it's funny now. In that moment, I was like, damn, but now I'm just like, oh, whatever. If she was going out, I would have had a snarky comment, too.
All right, good. I'm honestly, in all sincerity, I'm glad to hear that, because I hate when the people come out and they're bitter, and then we have fights, and then, oh my God, what's her face? I can't even think of people's names right now.
I just want to get drunk with all of them.
Just get drunk with all of them and have fun. It's not, I was going to quote Steve and go, it's game show in parking lot and whatever the hell he says. Sabetta in the chat room wants to know, Jason, who do you think is going to strike the other one first, Austin or Julia?
Ooh, I think it won't necessarily be either of them. I think somebody else is going to come into power, and then they'll pick off the other one. So I'm seeing Austin probably going first. Julia has sort of shown, or we have only seen her half the damn time, but she hasn't really shown to be a comp prowess. Every comp that Liz ever won while I was in the house was Liz playing, not Julia. Mm-hmm. So I definitely think that Julia will be a little bit safer than Austin if it really comes down to a week where one of them has to go. But I honestly think that out of those, the three-headed monster, Liz is the biggest threat. And if they were smart, they'd actually aim at Liz and leave Austin and Julia there disjointed together.
Yeah, and I mean, all right, so let's say
they're both going to be mad about it. I mean, they're both going to be mad that you take out Liz. But at that point, once we're down in the game where we're breaking up the twins in Austin, mm-hmm. they're going to be mad no matter what the hell happens.
Let me ask you this, because this is something that really annoys me, and it has to do with the twins. It has to do with, like, Survivor blood versus water. I get why Julie or Liz would be upset if the other one gets voted out. But at the end of the day, your family, your specifically twins, I mean, I guess this is not really a question I can ask you. So again, I will say, people, I think it's ridiculous to think that family members on Survivor Blood vs. Water or twins playing in the Big Brother house are not going to share the money. It's completely different if it was like Jason and his friend, but even then I would think, or it's like when it's family, I never understand when people are like, oh my God, it's mother against daughter. They're going to see each other when the show's over. They're living in the same house. Hey mom, how's that million? I'd like some lunch money. Nope, can't do that. I don't get it. They're sharing the money, obviously, is my opinion, but whatever. Mm-hmm. I just, it'll be interesting. I think a lot of people, we had Brendan and Rachel on, I guess, 2 or 3 days ago, and I didn't even think of this. Brendan said, America wants to see Liz get voted out to see if Austin will hook up with Julia.
Ooh.
And I was like, Brennan.
Well, we all know that ain't happened because Julia ain't built like that.
Yeah. I'm like, Brennan, I don't think that would happen at all. But he's kind of seemed to think it would.
Interesting to see.
It would be interesting to see. He also said, and I don't know how I missed this, Austin has never been on the block.
Yeah.
Had I missed that?
I kept begging everyone. I was like, why is it, especially in the bottle of block days, I was like, listen, you can't let anybody dare at this game again. Like, if the person never gets themselves on the block, they have the perfect thing to say at the final two chairs. Like, stick them up, even if they win the battle of the block, just to make sure they can never say they've never been nominated. And all these people have just let Austin's big Goliath ass keep going on, and I don't understand why.
Right. I don't understand why either. But I mean, well, not for nothing, you all left the twins in too. You're like, hey, twin party and three people voting together. Let's let them stay. I know why you guys.
Well, I always want to take out Austin and leave the twins because honestly, without Austin, I probably could have worked with the twins. They would have looked mm-hmm. for something. And what I should have done, obviously, is approach the twins and say, listen, Hookers, I know. But instead, I was playing it like it was Big Brother 5, and they were never going to be on this. So,
right.
They sort of outdid me on where we are in Big Brother world now. And I was, even before I went in, I was like watching the classic seasons, like shout out Big Brother 4 and shit. So I was probably way too far back in my brain to think of like Big Brother 15, Big Brother 16, how people play the game now, because I was playing how we played 10 years ago.
Right. Has Danielle Reyes reached out to you yet? She picked you to...
I think she has.
Okay, good.
Literally, I have so many people that have reached out to me. I feel so bad because I'm so obsessed with like everyone that's ever played this game. Even people that I like hated on the show, I'm still mildly obsessed with. And I wish I could really like talk to all of them. But it's also so awkward to talk to them because I'm like... why do you guys want to talk to me? Like, these are like my BB queens, and how do they even know my name? It's still really weird.
You know what's going to be really weird, Jason, because I'm going to be mildly evil right now and ask you a question that I just thought would be fun to ask you. Okay. Whose side are you on, Reagan or Andy?
Ooh, I have what is going on with this? Mm-hmm. I don't know the full tea about what they're beefing on.
Well, then it's going to waste too much time to explain it to you. I'll just say, bottom line, like, Reagan says Andy is too obsessive, like, wants to be his friend really hard, and Reagan's like, I just don't want to be your friend. I'm just not that into you. And then, like, throws a bunch of shade at Andy, and Andy's like, you're a dick, and what it's, you would have to read it all. So fine, pass. Let's ask a chat room question. Emily 7705 says, do you think Steve's awkwardness is real? I'm personally not a fan of Steve, but I think he's playing it up for the house guests.
He's definitely playing it up because there's moments in there where you see him not being that awkward. Mm-hmm. He really does fit in socially, and he's Mr. Stefan, and everybody really likes him. And then there's the moments where he just like twirls the hair on his leg and looks like he wants to crawl out of his skin. So I definitely think that some of it is put on, but some of it is his actual social insecurity that just reads through. In the first week, me and James put him on the spot and sort of interrogated him about snitching, and he looked like his brain was dripping out of his ears. He just could not handle it. So I think there is a fine line, but with he's getting better as the game goes on. I think at this point, it's mostly put on.
I think so, too. I think so, too, because there were times when my heart broke for him when he's like, I had no friends, nobody liked me my whole life, blah, blah. And I'm like, oh, my God, I feel so bad for Steve. Then the next day he's in the pool and he's like, I had a girlfriend and I was kissing her and all my high school friends were like, and I'm like, what the fuck are you talking about? Well, yesterday I felt bad for you, you fucking psycho. Okay, anyway, Sweet Sean in the chat room wants to know, Jason, do you hold any grudge towards Shelly and Clay? They both say their number one regret is now not keeping you, and I guess listening to Austin. So do you have a
That's why I don't hold a grudge, because I don't think I'd hold a grudge either way, because I mean, seven of those people voted me out. I'm not holding a grudge against any of them. But it's good to see that Shelly and Clay realized that when it really came down to it, they could think whatever they wanted about me, but I was a loyal person in that house. My game was very, like, Jeff and Jordan classic. Like, I was just going to be loyal to my deals, and if you had something with me, you could trust me to the end. So they could have trusted me to the end, and then they overthought their cards and thought, oh, maybe let's get rid of Jason now. And then they both went right after me. So it's good to know that they see that I could have changed their whole game for them, and I would have happily took Clelly with me to jury, just because I clearly was not playing with Austin, so I would have had to roll with Clelly.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, that's a good point. You would have had to roll with them. Just Swift Now, 40769, who is one of your, we're going to go with really big fans, Jason, wants to know, he's starting high school next week and wants to know if you have one tip you can give him for...
Okay, well, my one tip would probably be like 90. How about let's just start with don't do what Jason did in high school. Actually go to school. Period.
Okay, that's a good one.
Don't skip and think that you're like 23 and too cool for high school. Do your damn homework. Try to go to college because you ain't trying to be in mama's basement working at the supermarket. Period.
There you go. Stay in school, kids, and stay off the drugs.
Exactly.
Otherwise, end up like Vanessa. Okay.
I go to Zings, and I don't know.
Oh. That might be the worst. Okay, do you have Zings? Do you got Zings, Jason? All right, we want to hear Jason Zings. Go for it, Jason. Give us your Zings. Do you have one for everybody or only have for certain people?
I actually wrote one for everyone, including evicted people, too.
Oh, my God, Jason. Wait, hold on. Let me go full screen Jason for Jason Zinging. Okay.
They're probably not that good.
They're that good, Jason. You got
it. I did them last night at like 2 in the morning. And was like, if I'm going to zing these people, what am I going to say?
All right, I'm ready. Okay.
So, Austin, you wish I was your jockey. Sorry, I don't sit on horses. Period. You look like a horse.
Good. Next.
Liz, so Fingergate happened, and I've seen that man's hands. May we all pray for your innards.
Okay. Zing.
That was probably more of a zing to him, too.
Right.
Julia. Thanks for trying to control your sister. You suck at it.
That one I like the best. In chat room, we want to know which one you guys like the best. So I'm going to ask you guys at the end. All right, go ahead.
Meg, Princess Goblin Jello Legs. You have tried your best in all these challenges, and that's why we are so embarrassed.
I'm just trying not to joke.
It's clear you got a thing for Meg. Too bad when this is over, you won't ever be tasting that Jello. You'll be back to bread. I don't know if you know about his bread.
Yeah, we do.
There you go.
Okay.
Johnny Mack, The only thing less confusing than your laugh is how you became the most attractive guy in the house by default.
Shave your back.
Yo, when they nailed that was something else. He had a staff spot come off. Mm-hmm. Steve, you think the cameras are following you, but they're actually running away from your sexual advances. Here's Vanessa. I see your hat is quite stretched out and worn, just like your mental stability.
Aw, but it's production's fault for not giving her a meds. Go ahead.
Shelly, so I know you regret turning your back on me. But I'm glad, because then I could see how cheap your extensions look.
Wow, okay. Wow, the chat room loves that one.
Clay, have fun on your first day of second grade, Shelly's son.
Oh. I think he'll find that funny.
Was hit by a train in the face and remained alive. Her existence is a zing to the rest of us.
What?
Devon's in that good. Devon, you lied about your job. If only you were able to lie about what a bad bitch you are, you might as well still have been there. Jace, that was last year, right? I don't know him.
Neither does the memory wall.
Oh, God. Jeff, you talked a lot to everyone. If only maybe you would have used that mouth better, maybe you could have been Liz's feet shield.
Ooh.
Audrey was a thrill. And stocks are up in Fleet, Bankit, and Pfizer. Thanks for your contribution. I actually had to Google drug company names for that one.
Well, I like it. I liked it.
I don't know where I'm at now. Oh, Jackie. Thank you for truly being my second closest ally, even if unofficial. Thank you for bringing your 22-inch extensions and eyelash add-ons. And most importantly, thank you for not working at the Glitter Gulch.
Oh, Jackie.
That's all I got.
That's all. Jason, I have to say, round of applause for Jason Zings. I have a feeling we'll be seeing them as gifts and mashups real soon. We love them. We love them. Okay, so chat room, let me know which one of Jason's things do you think is the best? Yes. So far, Shelly, I see a lot of Shelly's and Vanessa's are winning it. You're far and away winning with the Shelly's and Vanessa's. Now, before any of you people go crazy and go tweeting all the horrible thing, zings and comedic, everyone. Zingity comedic.
Oh, my God. I can't say anything without being problematic. Everyone has no sense of humor these days.
Well, I got news for you, Jason. I think people that are here understand we do comedic recaps. And I say the people that follow and know and watch these shows, I think, are pretty good. They're really good at knowing that. So I wouldn't worry about that. Jason, a lot of people want to know, because I know we only got like 10 minutes left, and then we all got to go watch Big Brother. A lot of people are dying to know, but more specifically, I want to get your name right. Jason R. in the chat room wants to know, are you planning on doing any fan meet and greets?
See, this is like, I don't even understand this either. I would love to do fan meet and greets. I just don't even know how to go about beginning to get myself into that. I feel like I need a damn publicist or something, because I don't know what the hell to do. Even they're going to like host at clubs. Am I supposed to like call clubs myself and be like, can I come through? I just don't even understand the concept of all this. I would love to do fan meet and greets. I've met a lot of fans. I take a lot of pictures now. I love that. I love to hear what other people think about either what was going on while I was there or about they wanted in and stuff like that now. I would love to do fan meet and greets, but at this point, I have nothing planned.
Okay, Jason. Oh, my God. Okay, first of all, it's because you work and you have a job and real other things happening in your life, which is why you don't know about it. But because it's not like your sole source of money is Big Brother fans, which is awesome. So... We'll talk after, Jason. You have so many options available to you. Christine said the same exact thing, too, when she got out. And she was like, I would love to, but, you know, how do I do that? And would anybody even come? And da-da-da-da-da. Yeah, people come, and we can totally tell you how to go about that. It's very easy, Jason. And you'll make money. You'll make money. I'm sure places would pay you hundreds of dollars to show up. I mean, let's put it this way. If Caleb is getting paid to appear at a gay club,
after his rant?
Exactly, Jason. Exactly. So after his...
Again, we know how the gay club works. They just care if you have pecs. They don't care what the fuck comes out your mouth.
That's pretty true. But I thought it was still a little ridiculous. But yeah, he got paid to go do an appearance. Well, you know what? Now, if I just wanted to be really zingbot shady, I'd say, actually, the only reason he got paid probably was because Audrey Clay and Jace were there. But whatever. Ooh. Keep selling stuff out of your garage.
That's fine.
Keep selling stuff out of your garage. It's awesome. You used to make Cheddar Bay biscuits. I was really excited when I was in the supermarket and saw your lobster biscuit. You remember that on the feeds, don't you, Jason? How he had like 15 jobs on his season. He's like, oh, I was a hunter with my dad, and my dad was a senator, and my family makes the Red Lobster biscuits. I lost it when he was like, my family makes the Red Lobster biscuits. I was like, you got problems.
I think my favorite is still his dad breeding weird dogs.
Right.
He was a compulsive liar in there for sure.
Yeah, and still is. And I'm just saying, side note, if you flex shirtless on camera for guys giving you money, you're probably gay, Caleb. Mm-hmm. Just saying. Side note, don't want to, you know. Okay, so he compared, guys. Okay, give me your questions for Jason. We got like 5 more minutes. We can try and rapid fire through some questions if I can stop this. If you, Kayla Cairnis wants to know, if you could go back in the house right now, who would you make an alliance with? We know.
I would actually probably make an alliance. Well, I would make an official alliance with Johnny Mac. We were always roughly working together, but not really deeply, just on a surface level of we're not going to do each other that dirty, but that didn't really turn out. Obviously, I go back to my people. If my people were all dismantled and I went back, I would be forced to go with the twins in Austin.
Oh, okay. Interesting. I got to say also, we're seeing a lot of this in the chat room too. Make sure people are saying when you do your meet and greets, people want Jason merch. And let me tell you again, Jason, what I just wish I was just 10 years younger and you, because you got, oh my lantern, you have your tagline, Jason. Like, you got the tagline, you got it all happening. Yeah. Paper and plastic is the show. Oh, my land is your tagline. That shit's on shirts. You're doing meet and greet. You're charging people. You can stop stocking shelves.
Okay.
You can do it. We're going to make it happen. And then you got the Vanessa money rolling in. Don't forget about the Vanessa money rolling in. You got that too. That can be your like retirement. Production doesn't interfere with the show at all. Chat room that keeps asking that question.
Not at all.
Not at all. Are you a Nay?
I damn wish I was praying for a photo booth shit. A phone booth.
Yeah. Debbie L wants to know, are you and Meg going to get together after the show is over? Meg said she would be looking for you in the audience. Before you answer that, this is why I love Meg. Girlfriend, he's on the stage. He's on the stage, honey. Well, she thinks she's at camp, Jason. She thinks this is camp. Like, honest to God, she thinks she's at camp. I love Meg. I love Meg the person. I love Andrea Belkin. Like, I love these people. But girlfriend thinks she's at camp.
Yeah, she kind of does.
How did Andrea not?
I will be on the stage. She's not going to have to search for me in the damn audience. I'm going to be waving at her. Hopefully through a TV screen and not on the other side of the stage of the people that kick my butt but still get to vote.
Right. Exactly. I mean, look, I'm not losing hope of, I definitely want someone pre-jury to win fan favorite. And if not you, at least somebody pre-jury. Because I'm telling you, you guys are all the entertaining people. But whatever. We've already said that. We can move on. You're getting a lot of virtual hugs. Lots of people want you to know you got virtual hugs, Jason. Are you okay with Vanessa targeting Meg in the house right now? A lot of people are saying.
I mean, I think it's dumb to target Meg. Like you said, she's at summer camp. Meg thinks this is like sleepaway. She doesn't know really. She is good socially, but down to the brass tacks of Big Brother, Meg doesn't really know what's going on that much. So to target her is just kind of silly.
Yeah, it is kind of silly. Is brass tacks the stupidest alliance name?
Well, I honestly think almost all of them this year has been stupid as hell.
Scamper Squad.
Oh, God, that one is a hot mess.
But they also change them every other day. Like, every other day, there's a new alliance.
Exactly. So that's why it's like, I can't even hold up to that. I mean, we had the After Dark crew, which is just a play on words of LNC from season 8. So mm-hmm. We knew that that was nothing relevant or original. And then the Goblins. I know everyone in Bigger Universe. Stop yelling at me. I know it's Ashley and Pilar. I know they were the Goblins. We didn't name ourselves the Goblins because we want to be Ashley and Pilar. Meg was calling me a goblin in the diary room ever since the Nova Scotia, the very first veto that he spelled trombonish. She was calling me a scampering goblin looking for lettuce and stuff. Ever since then, it was goblins. I didn't go in there saying I wanted to be a goblin. So fall back.
Exactly. Exactly. I don't think people...
You
know,
saying that to me. I'm like, I love Ashley and Pilar. Please sit down.
Yeah, that's a lot of a question in the chat room right now. Still, even while you're explaining it, still asking it. Have you ran into any fans? Have you had any awkward fan run-ins? Victoria wants to know in the chat room.
Oh, I've had like a few that were a little. I had a girl invite me to her wedding when she was really drunk, and I was just like, okay, hi. And the other one was probably pretty funny. It's like 1 a.m, I'm walking to a gas station. This nice, young, effeminate, probably gay guy goes, oh my God, it's Jason. And I feel, I'm not even thinking. I'm just trying to go in and buy my pack of cigarettes and go home. So I totally steeped him. I was like, oh, nice to meet you, and just kept walking. And then right as I came out, I was like, ooh, that was bad, Jason. You should have, like, stopped and talked to him. But sometimes you're just busy with normal life, and you're like, oh, my God, my city is sort of small. So I'm going to get recognized at least once every day because there's somebody. I mean, I even went to Providence, which is a good 30 minutes away, and I'm in some random bar called the Trailer Park, and somebody in there recognized me. I'm like, I can't go anywhere. I'm hoping that sort of fakes up.
I think you're kind of stuck with that for at least a year. And I think...
I got a year to go.
Yeah, until you get the next crew rolling on in. And especially, like I said, so many people are using you kind of as the face of Big Brother still now. So you could have bigger problems, Jason. We just got to show you how to market it and use it to your advantage. We want the good people using it to their advantage. All right, everybody. I know Big Brother's starting. We all need to go watch it. We'll all be on Twitter. If you guys are in now, right now, and you like having Jason here and you want to see more people here, make sure you become a fan before you leave. Jason, where can the people find you on social media?
You can find me at the J Roy on Twitter. I have a Facebook now. I don't know how you can find that because I don't even know how to work that website. And I have a Snapchat. Feel free to harass me on that. That's also the J Roy.
All right. So the links are going to be below this video, which will be archived on our website, yourlotterycaps.com/BB17, where you can see our other interview with Jason and all of our interviews with the house guests. And I'm glad you were honest about the Facebook. It's going to be like, Jason, you don't check it. So I would go with Twitter and Snapchat, everybody. That's where I would look for the Jason. No, go wherever. Links will be below. Jason, are you going to be live tweeting during Big Brother right now?
I am.
All right, everybody. We'll see you guys over there. Bye for now, everybody. Bye.